Over the years, training your glutes has become more of a focus in the gym world rather than an afterthought. The glutes are a group of muscles that are comprised of the glute maximus, medius, and minimus. The glute max is actually the largest muscle in your body, so a complete physique requires that we train that muscle as a priority. And this muscle in particular will be the focus of this video. In this video, we will compare some common exercises that are used to train the glutes and determine which one is the best. My name's Nikki, this is QED Fitness, and before we start, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a future video. First up, let's compare two of the most common exercises which are used to train the glutes, the hip thrust and the squat. These two movements are great for training the glutes because they are demanding hip extension from the bent knee position. When our knees are bent, our hamstrings are shortened. Our hamstrings can also contribute to hip extension, but if they are shortened, they cannot contribute as much. So the only muscles left to do the work are the glutes. Think of how much your hamstrings contribute to a hip extension movement where your knees are relatively straight, like the Romanian deadlift. But if we bend our knees and then perform hip extension, the hamstrings can't contribute, so the glutes will have to work harder. So let's look at the activity of the glutes in the two movements. First up, the squat. Everybody says that squats are great for training the glutes, and it is true that after a heavy squat session, you may have sore glutes, but the way the glutes contract throughout the movement is what matters. So let's go a little bit deeper into the squat. During the eccentric or lowering phase of the squat, contraction through the glutes is actually relatively low. It reaches its lowest point at the bottom of the squat. Then, once we stand up out of the hole, the glutes will need to contract concentrically to drive us up from that bottom position. With the glutes contracting hard to drive us out of that bottom position, once we reach about halfway out of the squat, the contraction levels through the glutes begins to drop, and it reaches its lowest point once we reach lockout, where the glutes aren't doing very much at all. So this means, during large portions of the squat, the glutes are not doing a lot of work. The reason why you'll often have sore glutes after training squats is because most of the work they are doing is contracting eccentrically under load, which can lead to more muscle soreness. It does not mean that they are working to their fullest potential. Now, let's have a look at glute activity in the hip thrust. From the bottom position, to raise our hips up, we need to contract our glutes concentrically. Essentially, on the concentric portion of the hip thrust, the contractile demands on the glutes are increasing at the same time as the fibers shorten. On the eccentric or lowering phase, everything just happens in reverse. The fibers will lengthen as the contraction levels drop. So that's a pretty simple analysis, but hopefully you can see that there is no point in the hip thrust where there is not substantial tension throughout the glutes. Compared to the squat, which had varying levels of contraction throughout the movement, the hip thrust had a steady amount of concentric and eccentric contraction throughout the entire movement. So to train your glutes, you simply have to be doing the hip thrust, and here is how to do it. To do a hip thrust, we are going to begin with our upper back resting on a bench with our feet flat on the floor. You want to pick a stance with your feet that is comfortable. You don't want your knees too far in or too far out. You want your upper leg to be anywhere from parallel to your normal squat angle. As long as you're not picking an extreme, this won't affect the movement so much. But what is going to be important is the placement of your feet relative to your knees in the sagittal plane. The closer your feet are in towards your butt, the more the hamstrings will be shortened. And remember, when your hamstrings are shortened, they can't contribute to hip extension as much as normal, so the glutes will have to do more work. There will be a point of diminishing returns, so you don't want to have your feet in literally as close as possible, but bring them in close enough till you feel your glutes really start to fire a bit more. From here, it's a simple matter of raising your hips up into extension and squeezing your glutes at the top. A common mistake is to trick yourself into thinking you got hip extension by arching your lower back. Make sure you don't do that by contracting your abs and keeping your hips locked down. Some coaches will tell you to transfer your weight back onto your shoulders. I don't suggest you do this. The reason is because it changes the mechanics of the movement slightly and gets your quads involved more than you would like. You want to focus on bringing your hips straight up and straight down and squeezing those glutes at the top. So there you go, my friends. That is how to do, in my opinion, the most effective glute exercise out there. I hope you got something out of this video, and if you did, please subscribe to the channel and share the video. If you did, I will love you forever. My name is Nikki, this is QED Fitness, and remember, knowledge is power. Catch you next time.